Welcome, Anand all. Myself K. Srisha, working as assistant professor in MVR Engineering College in Mechanical Engineering Department. Today we are going to start a new topic and new unit. It is a fourth unit. So in our fourth unit, we have topic is game theory. So briefly, we are going to discuss what is about the game theory. So in game theory, we have three situations. So first of all, we will talk of about the game theory. So the game theory is nothing but a decision making situation. It is a decision making situation. How we will take a correct decision in a correct time. So that is nothing but a game theory. Okay. For example, if we will take a one coin and toss that coin. Already we know that a game. We know that game, so that is a toss. So if you want head or tail, so you will choose. If you choose head, we will win. The other one will fail. If you will choose tail, so other one will take tail. So decision is ours. We want head. So when you play the coin and toss with coin. So what the guess is, that guess correct is head, so definitely we will win. So if we will get it tail, so we will lose. So that is if we take what is the correct decision, so that is nothing but the game theory. I will just say I will give the example only. So in game theory is particularly nothing but the decision making situation. So in this game theory, we have three different types of situations. That is a deterministic situation, and another one is a probabilistic situation, and another one is uncertainty situation. So that is nothing but deterministic situation is 100, what we will choose, that is 100% is correct. So that is nothing but deterministic situation. What is the meaning of probabilistic situation? There is a chances. We have chances 50-50. Either it is correct or not. If it what we will choose, it is 50. We will get a 50% of chances. That is nothing but probabilistic situation. And it is nothing but the uncertainty situation. We don't know what is the exact decision is. Just we will guess. Wow, just guess. So just guess is nothing but uncertainty situation, right? And now we are going to see the terminologies of game theory. So in terminologies of game theory, we have we will take in the form of player A and player B. So that is nothing but we will take two persons we will take in the form of player A and player B. And next we will discuss the strategy. This topic is very important. So strategy is nothing but we have two different types of strategies. One is pure strategy and another one is mixed strategy. So what is that, the pure strategy? A pure strategy is nothing but player follow only one strategy. Okay, if you have he cannot follow more than one strategy. That is nothing but pure strategy. So for example, if we have the three probabilities P1, P2, P3, but I will take only one probability and remaining two probabilities I can make as both are zeros. At that the sum of probability we will get one. So how we will get the total sum of it would be one. So I will take only one probability, choose or follow one probability as a strategy. The remaining two are zeros. So 0 + 1 + 0, the sum of probabilities is equal to one. So that we called as the pure strategy. We can follow one strategy, that is we called as a pure strategy. So mixed strategy is nothing but player follows more than one strategy, we can call as mixed strategy. That is nothing but the sum of probability is one, but I will take the strategy more than one, that is we call as a mixed strategy. That is P1 is 0.6, P2 is 0.35, and P3 is make as zero. So the sum of probability is nothing but one. So here we can observe one thing. I will take only one strategy, that is we called as pure strategy. I will take more than one strategy is nothing but a mixed strategy. Okay. if you saw the problem, if you see the problem, so you will understand very easily. So next, so this particular rectangle we called as a payoff matrix, right? So here we are taking player A and player B, and we are taking as these are the players 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3. So these are the player 1, 2, 3 for B and 1, 2, 3 for player A. Okay, so the total this problem we call as the payoff matrix. So the particular rows and columns we will call as the payoff matrix if we take the game theory, right? So here, if the outcome here in this outcome, so this particular matrix we will get the outcome. That outcome we will get if we can get positive, so player A get game and lost to player B. So that is nothing but if we take a toss, if I will get a head, I got a profit and another player got lost. So that means I got a positive value. So that is the meaning of I got the profit and another player got the loss. That is the meaning of positive. So if I will take a player, if I will take any outcome is negative, that is nothing but player B take second strategy and player B also take second strategy, but the final outcome is negative. Final, because of a player A is will choose the negative value and player B also choose the negative value, but the final outcome is negative. So what is that meaning? So what will I give the guess is wrong for player A. So if I will get the outcome is negative value, the player A get loss and to player B get a profit. So that is the meaning of that. What is payoff matrix? So okay, in this game theory we have two principles. What are their two principles? So that is maximin principle. So maximum minimum principles, that is the meaning of we will choose in all minimum values, we will choose maximum values. For example, 2, 3, 4. So for example, 2, 3, 4, those are all the minimum values. In that all minimum values, I will choose only maximum values. 2, 3, 4, what is the maximum value? 4 is the maximum value. Okay, so that is the maximizes the minimum of guaranteed gains of player A. If we will do problems, so it is easily what is maximum principle and what is minimum principle value. Minimum, mini, max, min, if we have maximum values, we will choose the minimum value. So that is the meaning of mini, max principle. What is saddle point? So those terms are very important. Well, while we are doing the problem, you can understand very easily what are the terms related. What is saddle point? Saddle point is nothing but maximin value is equal to minimax value. So that is the meaning of that. Okay. So maximin value is equal to minimax value. So the term will called as a saddle point. And next we will take the term is value of the game. So what is the meaning of value of the game? If the game has a saddle point, then the value of the cell at the saddle point is called the value of the game. So that is a meaning of in that particular cell, what is the game has a saddle point, then the value of the cell, particular cell will be called as the value of game. If we look at the problem once, we will understand very easily. And next, 2% zero sum game. What is the meaning of the 2% zero sum game? So I will toss the coin with two persons. I choose head and another person chooses tail. I got head, so I won the game. So another person choose tail but got head. So the person I got profit and another person got a loss. That is the meaning of I got positive and another person got negative. So positive plus negative, what is meaning of that? Zero sum game. So that is nothing but in a game with two players, if the gains of one player is equal to loss of another player, so positive of me is equal to loss of another person, so that we called as a 0% zero sum game. Okay, And next, game with pure strategy. Actually, we have the different types of, we have two types of problems. One is game with pure strategy and another is game with the mixed strategy. So today's class, we will discuss only what is a game with the pure strategy and what is game with the mixed strategy. So the problems are very easy if you can understand. So this is the problem given. So find the optimum strategies of the players in the following games. That is, this is player A, this is player B, and we have three columns, 1, 2, 3, and rows, 1, 2, 3. So here our right side, we will take row minimum, and our end of the left side, we are taking column maximum. So row minimum. So in this 25, 20, 35. So in this first row, which is minimum 20 is minimum, and next row is 50, 45, 55. In this three terms, which is minimum 45 is minimum. So next third row is 58, 40, 42. In this three values, which is minimum 40 is minimum. So this is row minimum. Okay. And this row minimum, I will select maximum value 20, 45, 40. What is maximum? So that is 45. So here row minimum, in this minimum values, I will select maximum value. So that is we called as maximin. So here in this minimum values, I will select, I'm taking maximum value. I will call it as it is maxi min value. And next same as like here, I will take column maximum. In this column maximum, so this is column 1, 25, 50, 58. 58 is a maximum value. That is max is nothing but highest value. So 20, 45, 40. So in this 45 is the highest value. 35, 55, 42. So in this 55 is the highest value. So in this maximum values, I'm selecting minimum value. So 58, 45, 55. So we, in this which is minimum value, 45 is the minimum value. So in this maximum value, I'm taking 45 is a minimum value. So this particular value, I called as this is mini max value, right? So this is maximum value and this is mini max value. Okay, so so maximum value is 45 and minimax value is 45. So that is nothing but maximum value is equal to minimax value. So whenever the maximum value is equal to minimax value, so hence the game has a saddle pawn. So whenever the maximum value is equal to minimax value, we got the saddle point. So how we will get the saddle point value? So what is saddle point value? So this maximum value, we got the second strategy, and minimax value also got the second strategy. So both two are coincident. So this value and this value, so cross it, this, so this is intersection value. So which are the intersection value we got, that is the value of the game. So our value of the game is also 45. Hence, the game has a saddle point at the cell corresponding to row 2 and column 2. So this is row 2 and this is column 2. We got the value of the game. So our value of the game is 45. Now we are going to optimal probabilities. How we will take optimal probabilities? So here, this is player A. This is player A. Okay, in this player A, value of the game is second row. So second strategy 1, 2, 3, in this player A, I got the value of the game is in second strategy. Okay, in the second strategy, I'm taking only here we have three rows and three columns, 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3. So I will take the probabilities in the form. I got the value of the game in second row, so that is 1, and remaining 2 are 0. So because we are doing the pure strategy, so our pure strategy, we will follow only one strategy, that is nothing but pure strategy. Here in Q2, in probability of Q1, Q2, Q3 also, here also we got this is Q strategy. Here also we got second strategy. Here player B, so this is the second, this is also second strategy. So I'm taking probability 0, 1, 0. So the game is pure strategy, is nothing but P1 plus P2 plus P3 is equal to 1. So that is nothing but 0 plus 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. Because of, we will select only one strategy only. Here Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 is equal to 0. Here our Q probabilities also 0 plus 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. So this problem is totally related to pure strategy. Pure strategy is nothing but a probability is taken as 1. in among all these three probabilities. Okay. And next game with mixed strategy. Consider the following payoff matrix with respect to play area and solve it optimally. So this is play area. This completely we called as payoff matrix. This is player A and player B. So this is a 9, 7, 5, 11. So first of all, we'll take row minimum and column maximum. In row minimum, 9, 7, 7, 5, 11. 5 minimum is 5. And the column maximum, 9, 5, maximum is 9. And 7, 11, maximum is 11. So first of all, we will take in this minimum value. In this minimum value, what is maximum is 7. So maximum is 7. In this maximum value, I will select minimum value, 9. So 9 does not equal to 9. So that is nothing but our solution will not get the saddle point. Okay. So when we will not get the saddle point, it is nothing but a mixed strategy. If you will get a saddle point, that problem completely related to pure strategy. If you will not get any saddle point, that is nothing but maximum does not equal to minimax. That is related to mixed strategy, not related to pure strategy. Okay, now we are going to solve the problem related to mixed strategy. So in this mixed strategy, we are taking oddments. How to take oddments? So first of all, 9 difference we will take of each row. So 9 minus 7. 9 minus 7 is 2. But not put the value here. So 9 minus 7 is 2. Just take the first row and put the value in second row. Okay. 5 minus 11, whatever here, the negative values you are not taken. So just difference it. Okay. So 11 minus 5. 11 minus 5, we got 6. This is second row. I will put the value in first row. At the same thing here, and 9 minus 5 is 4. This is first column, but I will put the answer in second column. So now 7 minus 11 is also 4. This is the second column, but I will put the answer in fourth column. So first take the value in second, and take the second and take the value in first. So that is the, okay, this is first row, put the value in second row. Second row, put the value in first row, like that only. So now we are going to take the probabilities. I will take probabilities. P1 is equal to take this oddment 6 by, come add this two oddments, 2 plus 6, 6 by 8. So that is nothing but 3 by 4. So like that, this oddment also, 2 by 6 plus 2, 2 by 8, that is 1 by 4. For Q, this is P1. So for Q, 4 by 4 plus 4, this is nothing but 4 by 8, 1 by 2. For Q2 also, this is oddment for Q, 4 by 4 plus 4 plus 4, 4 by 8, 4 by 2. Okay, so those are all the probabilities of P1 and P2, and this is probabilities for Q1 and Q2. In pure strategy, we got the probabilities easily, but in your mixed strategy, you take with oddments, then after we will get the probabilities. Understand? Now we are going to solve the value of the game. So the value of the game, we will denoted with the letter V, capital V. So now we are going to how to take value of the game. So I will just take this column, in just this column, 9 into 6 plus 5 into 2 column. This column is multiplied with these oddments. If you want to take this, just take row, 9 into 4 plus 7 into 4. Okay. If you want to take column, 9 into 6 plus 5 into 2 by add this oddments. If you want to take this row wise, 9 into 4 plus 7 into 4 divided by 4 plus 4, like that. Now I will take, if you take any one of the process, the answer will came same, whatever we will take the procedure. So 9 into 6 plus 5 into 2 by add this oddment 6 plus 2. So 54 plus 8, 54 plus 10 by 8, 64 by 8, that is value of the game. So if I will take 7 into 6 plus 11 into 2, add this oddment 6 plus 2. So I will got the same value. If we take in the form of row wise, 9 into 4 plus 7 into 4 divided by 4 plus 4, got the 8 value. Like second row, 5 into 4 plus 11 into 4 by 4 plus 4, like we got the value of the game is 8. So the what is the main difference between pure strategy and mixed strategy? If you will follow one strategy, that we call as pure strategy. If you follow more than one strategy, that we call as mixed strategy. So in our pure strategy, we will get the probabilities very easily from problem. But in our pure strategy, so if our minimax does not equal to maximum, so that will not give any saddle point. If you will not get any saddle point, we go for oddments. Then after we will get probabilities, and finally we take the value of the game value.